In this video, I'm going to show you how to create an Instagram-like heart animation similar to this inside Adobe After Effects. Let's dive in.
3, 2, 1.
Before we dive in, I just want to mention that if you are a patron on my Patreon page, you can download the Mogurt version of this and use it directly inside Premiere Pro. But let's dive in and see how to create this from scratch inside After Effects. So just to show you, this is kind of what we're going to do inside After Effects today. As you can see, we have a heart animation kind of flutter up. And this animation is very unique because first you'll notice that it's following a direct path. And animating this from scratch would be a little bit difficult. So I'm going to show you one pretty cool trick that you can do inside After Effects to make shapes follow a path and to animate along a path inside After Effects here. Before we get started, just download this heart icon. It will be provided in the link below. So as you can see, I just have this PNG of a heart. Once you have this, we can get started with the tutorial. So the first step is to create a new composition. So we're going to go up to Composition, New Composition. And we can name this Heart Animation. And then from the preset, you can choose whichever one you'd want. I'm gonna go with 1920 by 1080. And then for the duration, 10 seconds, frame rate, 29 seconds. Then I'm gonna click OK. The first step is to add in your heart. So I'm just gonna click and drag this into my timeline. And then I'm gonna click S to bring up the scale property and then just scale this down a little bit. Get it to the size that you want. And once you have this set, then we'll create the path that the heart will animate on. So to create the path, what you want to do is grab your pen tool, keyboard shortcut G, and then next to fill and stroke, just make sure that they're off. So if you click on the fill button, make sure that there's none. And then same with stroke, make sure there's none. Then what I'm going to do is just scale out a little bit by clicking this drop down. And next, what I'm going to do is start drawing out my path using this pen tool. So I'm essentially going to click once to create my starting point and then click and drag to kind of make the path in which the heart will follow, and then probably one more up here, then just click and drag. And once you let go, you have this path. Now you can refine this by just clicking and dragging these points. And you can just change this to however you want the heart to animate. Just keep in mind that it will follow this path here. So once you have your path set, to apply the animation of the path to the heart layer, what you can do is go into the path properties by clicking the drop down, go into contents, go into shape, go into path one, and then select path. You'll want to copy this, so hit Command C, then go to your heart icon, click P to bring up position, and then select the position parameter and hit Command V to paste it. And now when you click and play this back, you'll see that we have that animation here. Now what's nice is all you have to do to make this longer or shorter is just click and drag the last keyframe out or closer together. So if you want this really fast, you can do something like this. Or if you want it nice and slow and smooth, you can drag it out and make it a little bit longer here. So I like somewhere in the middle, maybe 215 here, something like that. And then we'll just add a fade out at the end. So probably right here, I'm gonna click T on my keyboard to bring up opacity, click on the stopwatch next to opacity, and then go out a little bit right around there and change the value to 0. That way it fades out at the end. So that's how you do this animation. You would just do this 3 more times in different formations to get a nice flutter effect. And as you can see in the end, it would look something like this as they're all offset. If we click U on our keyboard, you can see I clicked and dragged out the keyframes so that they all kind of stagger as they animate up here. So just to show you, to create the next one, what you would do is just delete this shape layer and then click and draw, once again, a path. Get kind of the way you want it. I'm actually gonna move this to the other side because I kind of want it to animate kind of like opposite to the first one, something like that. And then what we can do is just duplicate this layer. So hit Command D to duplicate it, click U on our keyboard, and then just basically unkeyframe the position by just unchecking the stopwatch. And then what you can do is once again, go into the path section and then copy this, hit Command C, and then click on the position parameter and then hit Command V. And you should have something that looks like that. And like I said, you can offset this, so you can just click and drag this out, and you can click and drag the last keyframe to make it a little bit longer. And you can click and drag these opacity keyframes out so that it matches a little bit more. So you should have something that looks like that. And that's essentially how to create this animation. You just do this two more times to complete it, or you can do this however many times you want, maybe 3, 6, 8, 10. It really depends how many hearts you want, but that's the overall process to create this animation. So that's how to create this. If you have any questions, leave them down in the comments section below. Like I said, if you want to download that Mogurt template for Premiere Pro, consider supporting me on Patreon. You can join and get access to a lot of different assets that I've created over the last year or so. But otherwise, that does it for this video. Thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you guys in the next tutorial.